Introducing to you first, fighting out of the red corner from United Fight Team. Give it up for Julian Bateau.
Julian Bateau challenging Javid Basharat for the bantamweight belt here, pro MMA. And Bateau, we saw make an absolute explosion in the contender scene when he knocked out Richard Mearns, a very highly, hotly tipped prospect on Contenders 20, I think it was. Knocked him out in the first round with a right hand. And he brings a lot of explosiveness to the cage tonight, Dean.
Savage power, good grappler, beautiful jab that's tailored for MMA, fast hooks, everything you want for a fight in MMA.
And he's got that Wanderlei Silva head tattoo on the back of his head. And in some ways, he's got the power that Wanderlei packs as well.
And introducing his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner from London Shoot Fighters. Give it up for Javid Basharat.
His foe, Javid Basharat, and let me tell you, if you've not heard of him before, you're in for a treat tonight, because he is one of the most dynamic, exciting young strikers on the MMA scene. Never lost as an amateur or pro. That's five fights. He's 4-0 as a pro, and I believe he stopped every single one of them. Two KOs, two submissions. Dean, he's dangerous everywhere, isn't he?
Super gifted and talented fighter. Started out in Taekwondo, but really evolved in MMA. Excellent in and out movement. And I just love the way he takes the back in the standing position. I hope we get to see that today. He'll just jump on somebody's back and fight for that neck from stand up and drag them to the ground. It's just amazing. So coming from such an awesome camp in London Shoot Fighters, of course they're going to churn out some absolute beasts.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're in for a treat here live on Fight TV pay-per-view. Sit back and watch this, because it's going to go off.
Ladies and gentlemen, this professional mixed martial arts contest will be fought over 3 5-minute rounds for the bantamweight belt here at Contenders. This bout is sponsored by M&M Flooring. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the red corner from United Fight Team. Give it up for Julian Bateau. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner from London Shoot Fighters. Give it up for Javid Basharat. Your referee in charge of the action, Mr. Dan Moverheady.
Okay, important to note, this is 3 5-minute rounds for the title, not the usual 5 5-minute rounds. So 3 5-minute rounds. Julian Bateau, as I say, was very impressive on his debut at Contenders. In the red corner with the all-black shorts, and Javid Basharat, a human highlight reel, fighting out the blue corner in those London Shoot Fighters red and black shorts. And Dean, do not blink when you're watching Basharat, because he'll throw spinning kicks and all sorts, won't he?
Yeah, he switches stances beautifully. You never know if he's loading up that rear hip to fire that leg down, or indeed he goes low like that. He's just so unpredictable. Does a beautiful job of moving in and out of range, drawing his opponent in, and then landing those counter shots when they come in.
I think for me, the worst thing that Bateau can do in this fight is give him the space that he wants. I think he's got to be all over him. Because if you let Javid Basharat just tee off on you, he's going to land something spectacular. He switched stances constantly, as you say, Taekwondo background, all manner of spinning kicks and stuff. But unusually, for such a good striker, he's extremely dangerous on the ground as well, isn't he?
Bateau is working on the outside, but he's not throwing anything. He's got to get real busy. He's got some killer hooks and some nice leg kicks, but he's got to circle down and cut off the fancy footwork of Basharat.
He's got a nice jab, Julian Bateau, but he can't let Basharat get comfortable here in the early going. He's starting to warm up. You see Basharat cannot watch this man. Got to go and get him. He's throwing Vitoa around. Nice knee to the head. Big right hand just whiffed there. Hey, and there's that spinning kick.
Vitoa looks a little bit flustered here. Hey. As he gets the trip.
He's gone straight to the choke, Dean.
Yeah, losing the head snap here to get him down to the mat, expose the neck, even circle to the back here. Looks like he's going to use that leg to flatten out Vitoa or even expose the back here. Potential guillotine, looks like the arm's in. Still can finish it from that position. Looking for the 10-figure choke or the go-go choke to distract. And he wants to switch to the back there, but Vitoa did a great job of using that left arm to stop Basharat circling around to his back.
Good work from Vitoa so far as Basharat looks to press his advantage on the ground. It's extremely dangerous on the ground. Two of his four wins by submission.
There we go. There he gets it. Now he's on the back. He's going to look to get the hooks in. Vitoa did a great job of firing his hips away from Basharat so he couldn't get those hooks. He's going to leave at the head round here to try and end up on top of Basharat in side control. Basharat has got that grip, the seatbelt grip there. He's keeping him nice and close. Looking for the body triangle now. He's going to try and shut down Vitoa and expose the neck.
That puts a lot of pressure on, doesn't it, that body triangle. He's looking for the submission, the rear naked choke, looking to slip that arm underneath the neck of Vitoa, soften him up with strikes.
Vitoa here now needs to think about turning around in this position. It's very tight, but the affordance of the traditional hooks on the inside of the hips doesn't allow you to turn because your opponent follows you. But in this instance here, you can see that he can turn inside that guard. It's more affordable if you have sweat or indeed blood giving you some lubrication in this position, but he needs to think about turning around in this position and really kind of defending his neck there, 2-on-1, and keep covered from the punches. But Vitoa doing a great job here. This is experience from Vitoa, staying safe in this position, Mike.
He's doing well so far. He's got Basharat on his back, but he's certainly not giving up. He's fighting for all he's worth, hand fighting, looking for that choke again. Basharat, he's got a minute 50 to work. I think, is that him, Dean? He's on the choke.
Yeah, he's got it under the chin. We're looking at the monitor here from our position. Their backs are to us, but that looks like he's under the chin.
This fight is over. Javid Basharat comes into the contender's cage and takes less than a round, Dean, to submit Julien Boutaud, and he's our new bantamweight champion here at Contenders, Dean.
The key there was the submission ability. It's kind of elevated by that real control on the ground. He really sucked the air out of Vitoa, kept very tight, didn't give him an inch to move, and slowly and methodically worked the hand underneath the chin for that rear naked choke.
Very, very impressive. And Javid Basharat, remember that name, because he's going places in MMA, Dean. You've seen him here on Contenders, and you're going to see him on many, many other shows, I'm sure. Just remember where you saw him first, because my goodness, that was impressive. He lifts
the
belt.
Can we have a representative from M&M Flooring to come and present the belt,
get
please?
Get the official announcement from Tom Vince. But Dean, as a BJJ brown belt yourself, you have to be very impressed with that.
I was really impressed the way he kept tight, and it's very difficult in MMA to keep that body triangle and stop people turning around or indeed going to the lock side and put
fighters
pressure on your
ankle.
Fighters
to the centre of the cage,
but
please.
It was the first round, no sweat, no lubrication there. Basharat kept him very close, used the seatbelt grip to keep that top control of the top of the head and the arm of Vitoa, and waited for the ample opportunity to sink that arm underneath the neck.
Ladies and gents, give it up for both these young men here in the cage, please. But your winner via rear naked choke from the blue corner, give it up for Javid Basharat. Our new bantamweight Contenders Professional Mixed Martial Arts Champion, ladies and gentlemen. So, Javid, right, so Contenders champion. You're fresh off a win on Bama as well. Yeah? You're being hailed as the next big thing in MMA by an awful lot of people. What do you say to that?
Just hard work all day. My team alone. Everyone in my team is a prospect or they're a superstar, you know? We're building a great team, you know? Great stable. My coaches, Alexis and Paul. Hard work every day.
Who's next? Who's next on your list?
It doesn't matter, man. What do you mean, who's next? I fight. I'm a fighter.
And what's the next stage? Where are you going to be fighting next? Do you know?
Wherever they want me. I don't mind defending this belt. Until I got in here, I didn't even know it was a belt, you know? So, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're going to be seeing this man on a big, big stage very, very soon. Let's hear it for Javid Basharat.